Hey, Bad Buddies. Paul Roberts, Artsy One here. And today, I thought we would do a whole other approach to making a Batman spear gun. Okay? Here we have the first one. And this is made by the people from the movie. And then we have this one, which the last video showed me making it. I was trying to get a more practical approach, but I used found objects, totally found objects, and went, well, too steampunk, because the found objects being totally about what it was made it that way. So what we're going to do today is a combination. We're going to go more for this type of a cool look, but with still much more functionality than this had, hopefully. Or at least much more believability, hopefully. Half and half. Part found objects, half modeling. The found objects are simply going to be additions to give a high-tech look, because finding small pieces that look high-tech is a lot easier than taking a great big thing and having every piece look high-tech. It's just, unless you've got a great budget like Bruce Wayne, you're not going to find it. So that's where the modeler comes in, the artist comes in, the sculptor comes in. I should mention on that last video, and the one before that, I talked about a world of movie making that's about 40 years in the past. So much has changed, and even though there were big budget Hollywood movies, they were done in Florida. And we didn't have huge teams and well-founded ways of doing things there. In fact, the unions were just barely starting to be talked about. I remember the first day on Problem Child 2, I got in there on the set and they needed to push that great big radar down on John Ritter. And it needed something else to make it look different because everything in our movie was red or blue or yellow. And so they said, let's put some lightning bolts on there in keeping with the look of the rest of the school. So I start painting away and someone comes over and says, you can't do that. Because there's a guy that's just called the on-set dresser, and by golly, if you do one thing that he's supposed to do, well then he doesn't look like he's important and maybe he's not needed, but it's so important for him to feel like he needs to keep his job. So I went back to the prop and scenic and set dressing fabrication area and continued along my artistic approach to what I gave to the movie from that vantage point for that day. I had to do so much because there wasn't anybody else. I had to pretty much hold the weight. Eventually, I called on for one more helper, and I also hired out that dog to my friend, which I knew was qualified, and lived right there in Orlando. Coincidentally, he's the one that helped me to get started to make my first cowl. The reason why I'm saying this is because some of these methods that I used were non-conventional because I didn't have a machine shop that I could farm it out to. I had to do everything. I did have some scenic painters that would take and paint some of the objects that I made. I did have some carpenters that would take my draftings and fabricate anything that's like constructional type of thing. But I had to make it from the drafts table to the fabrication process to the try this, try that. Something works, something doesn't. And so that's an unusual way. Everything's much more subdivided here in Hollywood. And I'm glad that I had that opportunity to carry the weight of the art department in so many ways. Because out here in Hollywood, I'd just be another guy. So that's great, I got to flex my creative muscles. So today what we're gonna do is we're gonna take these. They're free, right? They're free. Get them when you buy paint at Home Depot. Make sure you pick them up every time you buy paint. I forget. But you're entitled to a couple of them every time you pick up paint. Then I'm gonna take this, which I bought for my son to make little projects out of wood. And I would use these also, which are wedges. You can buy a whole bundle of these very inexpensively. The only problem is, instead of being perfectly flat like these, they're sloped, which is fine. Sometimes you want something sloped. It'd be hard to shave this down unless it was cut this way in a slope. So together, these help. And then these are a little thinner, the smaller ones. I'm gonna take and I'm gonna create the basis of the spear gun body out of these, which is gonna give me a lot more creative freedom just modeling these though. I'm keeping my modeling very simple. I'm not going in engineering parts. I'm not going in with clay. I'm not taking anything like a sketch or anything like that. I'm gonna make it up as I go, just like with the thingamajigs. Just like that. But instead of going down the road that all the objects take me down, I'm gonna go down a road that I maneuver more on. But not all the way, from design concept to architectural drawings to creation and fabrication, but just like the Bat Cave in Chicago and different projects that I've done through time, but just making it up on the fly with some modeling based on wood. So here we go. Let's get started.